Hi, everyone. Thank you so much for joining me. This is Vanessa Ruffes here with WCNC Charlotte, doing a little bit of a Facebook Live to keep you in the loop with some of the stories our team has been working on. As I mentioned in the caption here, we wanted to get you an update on a Where's the Money investigation our Nate Morabito has been working on for several months alongside WRAL's Keely Arthur. You might remember we actually did a Facebook Live about this several months back. And we told you about this landlord who had college student renters and seemingly did not like a piece of furniture. It was a beer pong table. But when it came time for these students to move out of the house that they were renting, this landlord charged them tens of thousands of dollars. So our team got to work to try to see whether this was a concern, whether there could be any recourse for these students, and ended up getting a lot of really interesting answers and seemingly now getting a pretty big solution. I see our Nate is joining us right now. Let me see if I can invite Nate to join. This is all wonderful new technology. So give me a moment here. I'm inviting our live feed, so give us a couple moments to get that set up. Nate, I am adding you to the chat, so hopefully.
I'm here. Yay! That was so easy.
I'm glad we figured that out.
Much quicker than the last time. I feel like the last time we did this was last fall when we first started investigating, and we didn't really know how this was all going to end, and we had ideas of how we thought it should end and hopes of how it might end for the people that deserve their money back. And today we are excited to share that there is a settlement in this case of this former landlord. She still is a landlord. NC State University landlord, also rents to UNC Greensboro students, had a history we found over, you know, almost 15 years of holding on to people's security deposits and then charging excessive fines and fees. I have a copy of the settlement right here. $25,000 she has now agreed to pay back. She denies she broke any laws in this settlement, but because she doesn't want this to go any further, particularly in kind of a court setting, she has agreed to make things right financially. That is amazing news.
It certainly is. And I feel like, you know, we do a lot of investigations over the course of a year, and some of them get results in different ways. This is an interesting case where we're actually seeing money coming back to some folks, which is super exciting. And I feel like there's also maybe a knowledge gain that folks can have courtesy of this investigation. I don't know, Nate, if you could talk a bit about some of the things that you discovered, and Keely as well. And I know Keely is a she's involved with a prior engagement, so hopefully maybe at a later time she can hop on this feed. But what are some of the things that you've discovered while investigating this story that you wish that renters could take away?
Well, you know, number one, let's start with what else the settlement does, because I think it's really important for this one specific landlord. Like, from now on, the state has basically come up with an agreement with her about how she is going to do business moving forward. So she has very strict guidelines she will have to follow. And if she violates those, she will have a significant civil fine, like, you know, $10,000 more. So I think that's a really big deal, number one. And I also want to point out, in this particular case, we have 90 days now for other former renters to come forward. If you feel like you rented from this woman and she owes you money, you can file a claim with the state attorney general's office, and they will review it. If you have documentation, you know, this price may go up even more at some point. You know, they're going to go through a process about kind of who else should be paid, if there's anybody else. On the broader scale, you know, this has resolved the issue for one person, for one landlord. But on the broader scale, you know, I think that something we learned very early on is that there are very clear laws when it comes to what landlords can do. And it all starts with your lease. You need to carefully review the lease. The lease is your contract. Depending on what is in that lease, that dictates what the landlord can and cannot charge you. And I don't know that A lot of people tend to look at the lease. You know, sometimes they're a boilerplate and you just assume there's things in there that are reasonable. You need to review it. And also, if a landlord violates the law, if they're trying to unfairly collect debt or charge you fees that are not in that lease, or they're being deceptive, there is a law that you could take that person to court. You know, of course, taking someone to court could cost you money. It could cost you time, but that is another avenue. In this case, we very early on alerted the Attorney General's office about the situation, knowing he has the authority to take people to court too. We heard from lawyers that maybe based on what the law says, that this woman possibly may have broken some laws. And that allowed us to get, you know, the top law enforcement official in the state of North Carolina involved. And he told us if this person doesn't cooperate and make things right, we are not afraid to take them to court. And that's also important here. Several people had not filed complaints with the Attorney General's office until we started investigating. And when you do that, the Attorney General can advocate on your behalf, not just, you know, renters. I'm talking about consumers in general. But for renters, also the North Carolina Real Estate Commission, that is another advocacy group that can really help people out too. So I think there's some lessons that we learned, but I think the biggest lesson is that let your voice be heard. Number one, people reached out to us, reached out to you, quite honestly, Vanessa. You got this tip thanks to your volunteering in this community. Someone trusted you with this information. You passed it on to me. We partnered with WRAL and we started investigating. But if we had not done that, if people filed complaints, there are also formal processes with state agencies where they can get advocacy too and possibly results. As you said, not everything ends as positively as this does, but you know, just the relief for these families and these college students to put this chapter behind them. This was a lot of pressure. And we also had previously talked to a woman with a disability that rented from this woman too. I mean, you're talking about vulnerable people, college students, number one, they don't have a lot of money, that are under extreme stress and pressure and trying to find whatever apartment they can. They're scrambling on these college campuses, or a woman with a disability, a service animal that's just trying to find a place to live. It just reminds you that there are people there that are ready to speak up on your behalf if you're willing to share your voice as well.
And I think you bring up a good point there, Nate, because, you know, you mentioned this, the fact that there is the potential for more than a decade of wrongdoing or more than a decade of this type of behavior from this particular landlord where folks seemingly didn't speak up. And I just feel like folks should know that they should feel empowered to say something. It just takes one person to kind of speak up. And that's really how this started, for the thread to start to, you know, as you pull on it, to unravel. And I'm so pleased with the work that you and Keely have done with this piece. And I really hope folks are able to take these results to heart, you know, as testament to, you know, what we're trying to do in the community, make things better, make things right, make sure that folks are, you know, being treated fairly and in accordance with the law, and that we are here and there are advocates, you know, that we can get you in touch with too, if necessary, if you feel like something is not being done fairly to you. So I guess where do we go from here? I mean, is this the bow? I know you mentioned there's some time, there's like a bit of a window following this where folks might have a chance to speak up about their experiences. Yeah, what can you tell about that?
Well, number one, I just dropped in the comments our story about the settlement. In that story, you're going to find a link to an online form for people who have had an interaction with this landlord before. They can now click on that form. They can fill out their information and start that claim process. But I do feel like this is a bow in this situation. You know, I feel like we're going to continue to keep our ears open. You know, to our knowledge, this woman is still renting out properties to renters and to tenants. And so we're just going to kind of keep monitoring that situation. And I think what this also does, Vanessa, is that it kind of sets the bar higher. This landlord and other landlords now know that we are all watching, not just us. The Attorney General is watching, the North Carolina Real Estate Commission. That agency is watching, and we expect these people to be held to the highest standard. We want them to do business fairly and with respect. And I think too, you know, you mentioned people should feel empowered. We deal with this often. Some people are afraid of retaliation, and we understand that. But you see what happens in a case where people are brave enough to speak up. And I think something that we discussed very early on, Vanessa, and Keely and I discussed, is doing this the right way. We could have easily just thrown something on TV and online quickly that would have no impact, but it would be sensational and it would get clicks or views. And that's not what we're interested in doing. We are all about impacting our community for the better. And that takes time. And we did this the right way. We talked to the right people. We kind of built our case that there are actual laws in North Carolina that prohibit this. And we found the lease. You know, we figured out what was in the lease, what wasn't in the lease. We escalated it to the Attorney General's office. And I think the more that you can do about like that, and you can do it right and take your time, it just goes a long way in showing that we really do care. And I think that it's just a call for people to reach out to us. People can be anonymous if they want when they send me a tip or send you a tip. We treat that anonymously if they'd like to. But even that is better than not knowing something's happening in our community.
It's so true. And I don't want to get into super specifics, but I feel like, and I'm sure you can, you know, agree with this from your long experience doing investigations, sometimes it surprises you the things that folks will sit on and not talk about for years and years and years. And when they finally decide maybe they want to come out with their story and tell what happened to them, you're like, why did you not say this sooner? This was so wrong. And it's infuriating to see that folks feel like, you know, they don't deserve the justice because they're just afraid either, as you mentioned, retaliation, or maybe they just thought, I deserve this, or, you know, there's nothing really I can do about it. That is one of the most frustrating things that I experience when folks do reach out. I'm like, just please let us know what you're going through. Don't just assume that this is normal behavior or that this is acceptable behavior.
So something that kind of struck me when I was investigating students with disabilities in schools and the long-term punishment that they were receiving, you know, I'm an expert on any given day on any given thing that I learn about based on my job, but I'm not in these people's lives, right? I pop in for a few minutes, a few hours, a few days, a few weeks, a few months sometimes, and then I look and move on to the next thing. People that are dealing with major challenges, they're exhausted. They are trying to deal with this themselves, right? And I heard from so many parents of students with disabilities who said, we've been screaming this for so long, but it feels like no one was listening. And our voice is almost gone at this point. It feels like it's not even worth it. And so I think that that's just a good reminder that people are living these battles every day. And it's exhausting. It was exhausting for these students that were dealing with this. I mean, I just wonder, had you not done your work in the community, had this tip even come to us? I don't know what other avenue people would think about doing other than hiring an attorney. And in this situation, there was no attorney needed. It cost nothing. And I just want to reiterate to people, a $25,000 settlement the Attorney General was able to secure with this landlord. People are getting their money back, all because people trusted us to tell this story and let us hold this landlord accountable and get to the regulators and say, what are you going to do to fix this?
Yeah. You know, I mean, I will mention how this came on my radar is, as you mentioned, yeah, it's through the volunteer work that I do in the community. And so I was aware of, I guess it seemed like some sort of strife that the mother of one of these students, you know, was feeling because on behalf of her son who was going through this, he was one of the renters in your piece. And she actually had posted on Facebook, she said, is anyone out there a lawyer who could do pro bono work for some college students? And I saw the post and I was like, oh, something's going on here. Something's not quite right. And so actually, I don't even think she thought this was a news story because I reached out to her directly and was like, is there something I could do for you, or, you know, our team could do for you? We have a great, you know, investigative unit. And she was like, I don't even know this is a news story. And after she told me, I was like, this is a news story. This is something that needs to be pursued. This is not right. And so anyways, I'm glad that things are working out this way. And I guess I know you mentioned you're gonna air a piece tonight at six, where you've actually sat down with this woman I mentioned and some other folks too. What can folks expect to see tonight at six in this follow-up piece that's airing on WCNC Charlotte?
What I love about these interviews that we did with a couple moms, number one of them, Carrie Parziale, the woman you mentioned, whose son Tyler Keeley was able to interview yesterday as well, is that they feel vindicated. They feel not only were they heard, but they were proven to be right. Of course, we knew they had the receipts from the beginning. I remember you coming to me with the bill, and it was in black and white that it seemed excessive and unreasonable and unlike anything we had heard before. And they knew it was true. We believed it was true. But for everyone else, including the attorney general and even the landlord, to say, look, we're going to make things right, I think is a big deal. And also, Tyler is the college student. He graduated in December. He was actually about to hop on a plane to go to Rome when Keeley caught him. And it was just like a wow moment. You know, I think he knew they were investigating, but didn't expect anything was going to come about it and come from it. And so knowing that his voice was heard and it made a difference, I think you're just going to see relief. They're just relieved that their efforts were not in vain. They're going to get some money back. This woman, you know, it's going to be very difficult for her to do the same thing she's been doing in the past. And again, there's widespread education now about what the laws are in North Carolina and what avenues people can take if they feel like they've been wrong. So I just feel like it's the perfect ending to this situation. And hopefully those that are owed money can get their money back with little trouble, and everything will be smooth from here on out for this particular landlord and her current and future tenants.
Yeah. I am once again just so thankful of all, you know, for all the work that you put into this, and thankful that, you know, it's turning out this way and that these folks do feel vindicated, as you said. Is there anything you want to leave folks with? I know we talked about the importance of giving us tips. You know, you never know what it can turn into. I believe our email address is newstips@wcnc.com, but of course we're always accessible via social media. I tagged you in this post, and I've tagged Keeley as well. So I would urge folks to reach out if they have any concerns that they feel like we can help them address. Nate, is there anything else you want to say before we wrap things up?
No, other than I know you get DMs all the time. So do I. People reach out to me through Facebook. That's something you could certainly do. Send me a message. We can start communicating. I prefer, for safety reasons, and you're better protected over email, which we'll eventually move over to if we have an initial DM conversation. But I respond to every phone call, every email, every direct message I get. And so we are listening. We are here to help. And whether or not you think it's a news story, let us decide that for you. Let us help you decide that. Because if you didn't ask that question to reach out, Vanessa, we wouldn't be here talking about that today.
All right. Well, we'll leave it there, folks. Once again, you've been tuning in for this big update on a months-long investigation. We will urge you, of course, if you want to follow up and learn a little bit more of the background of this story. Nate has dropped a link to the story in the comments, so you're welcome to read up on that if maybe you're new to this feed, new to joining us on social media, and you're not familiar with this story. But hopefully a happy ending for many folks. Sounds like that's the case, and we hope that you reach out if you need help. I guess we'll say adieu for now, and thank you again, Nate. Thank you so much.
Thank you, and thanks for the support. We'll talk soon.
All right, bye, y'all.